In this video, we will learn about how we can rename columns and how we can do sorting. So let's go to the Power Query editor. We just need to click transform data. And here it is, the Power Query editor. So let's copy this table. Control C, Control V. And here we can rename it like sales. And we have here, for example, ship date. So if I click, right click, and rename ship underscore date. So here you can see Power Query editor generated this code, where table.renameColumns and cType is the step that you can see here. And then this is the old column and this is the new column. So let's try to write this code by our own. We need to rename order date, ordered underscore date. So let's go to the advanced editor. So this is the last step. We need to copy this variable and we need to put here a comma. So rename order date. So the function will be table.rename columns, and the first parameter will be the name of the table. So what is the name of the table? It is rename underscore column. We just need to copy and paste. And then you can see here in the IntelliSense, the first parameter is the table and the second parameter it takes list. So we need to write here comma and one bracket. And here we have to write what's the name of the old column. This is order date, and the new name will be order underscore date. That's it. And now we have to use this new name in the output here. That's it. And here you can see we have no syntax error have been detected. So if I click done, you will see here order underscore date has been, this column's name has been changed from order date to order underscore date. So see what we are doing. We are here, we have renamed ship date. In the second step, we have renamed order date to order underscore date. So we are performing the same function. And what was the same function? We are just doing renaming. And if we doing performing the same operation, then we don't need to add multiple steps. So instead of doing in multiple steps, like if we have 10 columns and I need to change the name of the 10 column, then I don't need to write 10 steps here. So what we can do is we just need to click cross. And here we have to write comma, and then the second list, it is order date. So remember one thing, it is a case sensitive. So comma order underscore date. And then there is another column. So we need to create one more list. So this is like order number, the first one here. So order number. So we will use order number, and the new name will be order underscore number. That's it. So we need to click enter. And here you can see order underscore number, order underscore date. These two columns have been changed. So we have done all these changing in one step. And remember one thing, rename column needs one list. So what we are providing here, we are providing, this is one list, second list, and the third list. And these all three lists are wrapped in the single list. So it is a list of lists. So this is how we can rename different columns within one step and in multiple steps. So in the same way we will do sorting. So let's find some column like a delivery region index. So if you click, maybe we can click here and sort ascending. So the Power Query editor has generated M code for the sorting, and what's the name of the function? This is table.sort, and it takes the name of the column that contains the result from the previous step, and this is the name of the column, and here order dot ascending, right? So if we want to do like order quantity in descending, so what we have to do is we just need to enter comma and just need to use the name, or what is the name, just a minute, we just need to one more bracket. So this is the let me check. Order quantity. So this is the name, right? Order quantity. And we have to write here underscore comma. Order quantity comma order, this is the function, order dot descending. Here you can see, that's it. So we need to press enter, and here you can see the first column is delivery region index is in ascending order, and the order quantity it is in the descending orders. See the arrow, and the same arrow is upward, so it's ascending and this is descending. And if we look at the advanced editor, so here you can see this is the newly created step, the name is sorted rows. So let's do one more thing. If I try to rename this column, rename underscore column, then again I have to use rename a column here as well. And if I use this variable in many places, then in the advanced editor I have to do this modification as many places as we have used a rename column. So what we can do is now, we have to rename this variable, and it should automatically renamed everywhere. So just click cancel. If you change the name here in the applied steps, so like right click rename, and we can rename call, for example. This is the name of the variable. Okay, and now let's have a look in the advanced editor. So here you can see rename call, and it is automatically renamed here in the price tabs. So whenever you rename anything here in the graphical user interface, it automatically updated it in all the places. So in this video we have learned two functions of the table, like one is the rename column and the other one is the table.sort. So that's all about this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel.